So yeah, my house betrays me yet again. And I come home on Tuesday night and I go downstairs into my bathroom and I look up at my light fixture and there's water dripping from it. Not a pour, but a drip.
And have you done the sage thing? I've never done the sage thing.
At this point, I just need to have a full exorcism
on this house. This house is ridiculous.
Water is the worst. You've dealt with it.
Oh.
You've dealt with water. Water goes wherever water wants to go. I've had burst pipes. I've had hot water heaters that have given out. I had that god-awful sprinkler system that the guy put in himself and buried it too deeply and flooded my lawn. Dundalk Donnie, shout out, pal. He remembers. I had a grinder pump. You have to have this thing in the basement when you can't rely on gravity to get water and fecal where it needs to go. This thing sucks the water in like a hungry little boy, grinds it up, spits it out. Found a rat in there. That was fun.
Oh.
Well, I get this drip, and it was a couple of things. There is a crack in the edge of the shower. It's a stand-up shower upstairs. There's a crack in the tile that water was leaking out of. It was going around the edge of the bathroom. It was a small bathroom. And it was going into the air ducts. And somewhere in there, there's like a little crack in the air ducts. It's hitting drywall. It's leaking. Luckily, no burst pipes. Pipes are good. Oh, pipes are calling.
You have to count your blessings.
You know, each day above ground is hell on earth. So he also checks, my plumber, he checks the drains. Because a lot of time, it's these drains that they'll fill up and they'll start having water go places where it ain't supposed to go. Well, I run the shower for like 5 minutes. It turns into a bath. There ain't nothing going down that drain. And it's my stepdaughter's bathroom. And she's got this long, beautiful, flowing head of, you know, Rapunzel hair. And it occurs to me, neglectful homeowner, a lot of this is in my feet. I don't think I've gone up there and cleaned that drain out or pour like, I don't know. What's the
Drano
stuff? Drano. Thank you.
Yeah, the Drano usually works, but it's not forever. It's, you know, maybe, I don't know, 6 months.
It's
like, I'm one person.
Back. Yeah.
Okay, and I don't have Rapunzel. I pair, but
I mean, your pubes are at least 7 to 8 inches per long, flowing, jet black, Armenian, avocado furs. And you get soap. You get scum, you get body murk. It all turns into this slurry. He opens up the drain and gets down there with a little something. And I mean, essentially, just pulls out Cousin It from the damn Adams family.
Oh, yeah.
This creature, I was looking at it just waiting for it to start twitching and moving. I mean, I waited for it to blink. I thought about putting it up for adoption. The sound it made when I threw it away. Just take a handful of overly sauced pasta and spike it on a tile floor. Just, as it landed. And it got me thinking of like other plumbing nightmares. This one's pretty normal. It's about a 1 out of 10. But remember what they found at the coffee shop I worked at? A stone's throw from here. Over near Loyola.
I don't recall.
Years ago, Josh, in my younger days before radio welcomed me into its cruel bosom, I worked at a coffee shop up the way. It was owned by a lovely Israeli man, called it the Hebrew. And then it went through multiple changes. This was the place that had the gigantic vagina sculpture on the wall.
Oh. Huh.
And the toilet starts backing up in the women's room. Well, I'm plunging, nothing's happening. We got to call a plumber. Plumber comes out. He looks at the thing, he can't get it. He's got the auger, he's grinding away at it. Nothing's happening. He goes, "You got a basement?" We do. Downstairs, where we kept all of the, the dry goods, stuff like that. And there's pipes running along the ceiling. And he's looking at him, he's like, "Yeah, this is the one." And he's like tapping at it. Ding, ding, ding. Ding, ding, ding. Thung, thung, thung. Got your blockage. Women's room, right? Yeah. This pipe ain't good shape either. It's gross. It's corroded. Just saying it makes me want to puke. He goes, "You got a big Rubbermaid trash can?" I'm like, "Yes, we do. Multiple." position it under this thing. He's like, I'm going to have to replace this length of pipe. It was corroded. It was nasty. It had to go. He starts tapping on this thing. I mean, 30 seconds later, into the trash can is this Willy Wonka hot chocolate river of fetid feminine funk, the smell of which, the rotting corpse of 100,000 defiled years. This dude looks down at the trash can and goes, yep, that's what I thought. Jersey whitefish. I immediately feel my eyes water. And what I come to find out is that it's women flushing feminine products.
Oh, come on now.
And they fill up and clog everything. And you look down in this cauldron of nightmare chowder. And sure enough, look like a bunch of mice just in there for months, if not years, of women chucking their stuff down there.
This is the problem with women. You know, if this was a world full of men,
hell yeah,
we would have so many, we would have a lot fewer problems. Okay, just a bunch of dudes,
just bros hanging out with bros, man.
Figure out a way to procreate.
We'll try
scratching each other's backs.
That's what I'm talking about, dude. Giving Ned Hurst massages he didn't ask for, smooches on his forehead.
Why the thing that bothers me is why they made you plunge.
Well, I plunged it before calling.
Right, I know
a plumber. Oh, it was just two dudes on staff. There was no one else in there. It was like a two-man operation.
You know,
it was gross.
It bothers me.
410-338-1098. Love to hear your plumbing nightmare. I'd love to hear from a plumber. You found what in the drain? What the hell was in the septic? What the hell was the clog? 410-338-1098. 410-338-1098. Give us a plumbing nightmare. I'd love to talk to a plumber, someone that actually fished something horrible out of a drain. We just got a big old hair soap funk clog.
That's good. That's all it was.
Thank God there was no pipes, man. No pipes. There was a crack in the tile that water was leaking through. That's all been sealed up. It's good to go. But still, some of the crap you fished out of there, it's got to be a nightmare. Let's head to Eric. Eric, a plumber doing the Lord's work, buddy. Thank you.
You're welcome.
What the hell did you find, and where did you find it?
Okay, well, what, a couple weeks ago, I was at the Wakefield Apartments in Waldorf.
That's a bad connection.
And when I was walking up to the door, there was raw sewage coming out the front door.
Oh!
All the way, when I walked into the bathroom, there was about a half an inch of raw sewage all around the toilet. The bathtub was completely filled up, the toilet. Luckily, I found a clean out next door. Snaked it about 60-some feet, and I pulled out, like, shredded up shirts.
Shirts? Someone had been flushing shirts. Clothes.
Yeah, I mean, you know, for the people who don't have money to use toilet paper, they'll cut up.
Oh, shredded up shirts. God. Oh, so they were using, like, makeshift rags as, like, TP.
Yep.
Wow.
I hate the term raw sewage. Raw. That's one of my least favorite. It's just, I don't need, it's just.
It's a word you can smell.
Yeah.
Awful.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'd prefer to wipe with a Hanes cotton t-shirt.
Now, let me ask you, are you still there?
Oh, yeah.
So you hit that, you found a clean out, you open that thing up, you put the snake in there, and then all the water drops out of the tub and out of the toilet. From there, you're off the hook, right? Your job is done. You can just leave.
Yeah. Yep. If I made the mess, then I have to clean it up.
Got it. But that you just were like, okay, the rest is on you.
Yeah, not my monkeys, not my squeegee.
And grease smells worse than poop.
Pee-pee is the worst thing ever. Is that what you said?
Grease.
Grease?
Grease.
Yeah. Oh. Grease. Hey, yeah, I didn't even think about grease. Because we're only thinking bathroom. There's kitchen, too.
Kitchen backups. There's dishwasher backups. There's all kinds of backups. What's the soap a plumber uses to scrub the foul off of them?
It's normal soap.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you. Appreciate it, bud. Let's head over to John. John, line one. What the hell did you find?
Hey, good morning, guys.
Morning, pal.
I I used to be a maintenance technician in an apartment complex, and I was on call. So I got a call at like 2:30 in the morning to go to a one of the apartments, and the people were Middle Eastern, and they didn't believe in using the common washing machine, so they would wash their clothes in their tub. So I go to snake it out, and I get about 6 feet down with the auger, and I start noticing that there's some brown stuff starting to float up out of their bathtub drain. So I'm like, this is not good. So I go down in there a little more, and as I'm trying to bring it out, it splashes me in the face. I puke. Now I have to clean up that and my puke. I wound up getting a bacterial infection from it splashing me in my mouth, and I was in the hospital for 5 days.
5 days in the hospital?
Yes. And I don't work there anymore after that.
Oh, my God. Dude.
Shouldn't you guys wear, like, facial protection?
Like a shield
probably
or something?
Probably not a bad idea.
Yeah, well, yeah. I mean, I was wearing, like, those elbow gloves because I knew it was going to be nasty. But I wasn't expecting it to splash me in the face. And I also wasn't expecting number two in the tub.
I'm going to get sick, dude. Thank you for
I'm assuming
your service.
All those pipes probably went together at some. I don't think they were pooping in the tub. I think. Maybe they were.
Do you
know what
I know? It's probably easier to be a plumber, but still so disgusting. That would be in Turkey, Greece, Egypt, or Ukraine. Do you know what those four countries have in common?
They poop in the street.
They don't necessarily poop in the street, but when they get done wiping, they throw the toilet paper in the trash can. They don't flush it. It goes in the trash can dustbin next to the toilet because a lot of the toilets and the plumbing in those countries are old and they can't slurp it in there.
Yeah.
So you just have a trash can full of Egyptian toilet paper and they eat a lot of dates.